Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's read Ruth 1.
Arabaling Ruth 1.
Ruth 1.
Ruth 1.
Ruth 1, chapter 1.
Ruth chapter 1.
Verse 1.
Verse 1.
Just read, Mama. This place is very hot.
It says, "Now it came to pass in the days when the judges ruled that there was a famine in the land, and a certain man of Bethlehem, Judah, went to dwell in the country of Moab, he and his wife and his two sons. The name of the man was Eliakim, the name of his wife was Naomi, and the names of his two sons were Mahlon and Chilion, Ephratite of Bethlehem, Judah, and they went to the country of Moab and remained there. Then Elimelech, Naomi's husband, died, and she left and her two sons. Now they took wives of the women of Moab. The name of the one was Orpah, and the name of the other was Ruth, and they dwelt there about 10 years. Then both Mahlon and Chilion also died, so the woman survived her two sons and her husband."
Read, Mama.
"Then she arose with her daughters-in-law, that she might return from the country of Moab, for she has heard in the country of Moab about that the Lord had visited his people by giving them bread. Therefore, she went out from the place where she was, and her two daughters-in-law with her. And they went on the way to return to the land of Judah. And Naomi said to her two daughters-in-law, 'Go, return each to her mother's house. The Lord dealt kindly with you, as you have dealt with the dead and with me. The Lord grant that you may find rest, each in the house of her husband.' So she kissed them, and they lifted up their voices and wept. And they said to her, 'Surely we will return with you to your people.' But Naomi said, 'Turn back, my daughters. Why will you go with me? Are there still sons in my womb, that they may be your husbands? Turn back, my daughters, go, for I am too old to have a husband. If I should say I have hope, if I should have a husband tonight and should also bear sons, would you wait for them till they were grown? Would you restrain yourself from having husbands? No, my daughters, for it grieves me very much for your sakes that the husband of the Lord has gone out against me.' Then they lifted up their voices and wept again. And Orpah kissed a mother-in-law, but Ruth clung to her. And she said, 'Look, your sister-in-law has gone back to her people and to her gods. Return after your sister-in-law.' But Ruth said, 'Entreat me not to leave you or to turn back from following after you. For wherever you go, I will go. And wherever you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God shall be my God. Where you die, I will die, and there where I will be buried, the Lord do so to me and more also.'"
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
There's something that I want to preach to you, but it's a revelation that I got.
And
in this revelation, there's something like this that is going to happen.
Just
write the land where God planted you. There's a land where God planted you. I will speak slowly so that you understand this. The husband of
Naomi,
he was having things, but the famine came in the land of Judah. So her husband began to tell his wife, We cannot dwell in our land.
Rekasidule mohai.
It's better we go and search for greener pastures.
Aritzamanya riyonya katulo ye inangle mafulo.
And if you can read there, you see that a husband is the one that has encouraged his wife.
Aubala molauta lemore munna okie na ilengato telicha msadiya hai.
And they were having two sons as we have read.
Ne na ba na leba roba ba biri jolo kai rekuile.
The first thing, she was encouraged.
Ntoya matumo uila totelicha.
She moved out of the land that God planted her.
Atwale fasting le mudimun nammele olona.
And when she went out with her two sons.
Galonga itwa sipila leba roba ba biri.
When they were trying to make life there.
Abalika udiya bupilo balika ntekwale.
The one who encouraged her died.
Oh, anamo totelicha tokofala.
That person who encouraged died and she was left with two sons.
Motola namo totelicha tokofala shala fela leba roba ba biri.
And the sons took wives.
Eneba roba leba chia basadi.
She was witnessing.
Yeah, na na libele chabona.
Most of the time when I read this, I found that I cannot talk about a husband, I talk about Naomi.
Anche angata kitaba kisabulele kamuna kitaba kibulela kan Naomi.
Because the revelation is on Naomi.
Kaba ni kutola yansi itola hala mon Naomi.
When Naomi watched her sons.
Anaomi libele chibarwa.
Get married.
Banyala.
I'm sure she was encouraged.
Kia dumela wila toteleche.
She remembered that her husband is the one who encouraged her to go there.
Ah, oplorik munna ikena wa mututelecha uraya na kewe.
But unfortunately, they were in the wrong land.
Taba kotsi kure ba fitreli fasingle lisinglona.
Because if you can be in a land where God didn't plant you.
Kaora aukaya tulongi mudima sa ubaya ngoyona.
Your life can be terminated anytime.
Wapiloba hauka no ba fella na kuingwele ngwe.
And the Bible says.
And the Bible yare.
When the sons took wives.
Aba roba la banyala.
All of them also died.
Kamukana abona batokofala.
In other words, they were in a land where the breadwinners.
Kamanchama we ne balile fasingle batwa batsunjwa ba mafepe.
They don't live long.
Aba pilinako.
Therefore, the provision of them.
Ora ufepe wabona.
Was also limited.
Na ufukucheile.
So now the Bible says.
Zano Bible ya papa iri.
When the sons died.
Aba roba la batokofala.
Naomi began to hear.
Naomi atobo ukwa.
In the land where she had a husband and everything.
Aye kwale munna na le munna le julo kamuka ka ufela.
God has visited that land.
Modimo etechi le fasilela.
There's a harvest.
Ona le pulo engata.
And the Bible says she took her daughters.
Bible ra chia bosesiba.
I want to tell you something that I found a lesson somewhere.
Ke nyako le botsa ntwe ke tshotseng thuto mo go yona.
Because of her encouragement in the journey.
Kaleba kala uri na totheleche ile tseleng.
When she was moving.
Ha sipila.
She began to think about the dead.
Atomonana ka baba thokofetse.
She understood that now she does not need anyone.
Akwishishona asa thoka motho.
But she have to go back to the land where she was born.
Mara utsontjo ubiela ko yena tswetseng teng.
Where God want her to be.
Mo mudimo amunyakanga le gona.
And the Bible says
ere Bible
on the road
tseleng
she began to tell the truth.
Atomo thalosetsa nnete.
Her daughters in law.
Abucha baninya na ba.
There was one encouragement she gave.
Ne gona le unyamiwa o ti ya ubulecheo.
She says I can see you people you are matured.
Ore ke le bona le godile.
And I don't have hope with you.
And nakisa nakulufelo lelena.
Because I cannot give birth to a son.
Ka ring ka sabela ka morwana jwale.
And the son becomes your husband.
Ene morwana ata lenyala ka manje mangwe.
I'm going back but I can't promise anything for you.
Tanonki wena morao maranga sa litsepisa silo.
You know she was open to them.
Na bulehile mo bona.
But her mind was to going back to the land where God planted.
Mara mona hano ga ine ulu biela morao mo modimo a mo beileng teng.
And she was fair and say it's better I go back alone.
And ene leta ba e botsa bolelo re ga o ka one ke tsama ke le noshi ka hore.
His daughter is better they go back to their country.
Ba ready ba ka one ba no biela ko ba thang teng.
And the Bible says
Bible re
when this other lady heard that.
Ah o bonwa ikwa opera.
She turned back.
Abuela morao.
But this other one clung to.
Oh muwe a khumarela matswala hai.
You could hear what this one who clings said.
Wa khono kwa mantjwa bolela ko wa khumarela.
I want us to read those words.
Ke nyakore re yo bala mantjwa ala.
Those words are of saying.
Mantjwa la ara gore.
I'm going there with you.
Na ke a sipila ke tsamalo wena.
Your God
Mudimu wahao
will be my God.
Utoba mudimu waka.
You see, I want to show you something. Verse 16.
Molao verse 16.
But Ruth said,
Ewe Rutari,
entreat me not to leave you.
Senkapele choro kutuele.
Or turn back from following you.
Oraki wele mrao kisu shale mrao.
What Ruth was saying,
Tabaye Rutana ibulela shi.
I can see when I look at you, there's no hope.
Kia bona kulevela kulufela ibonale.
But don't even guide me
Maraska
so that I turn back.
Aure naki wele mrao.
Don't try to encourage me.
Osikaleka unpoteleja.
So that I turn back.
Oraki wele kumrao.
She says, for wherever you go,
Kaore hanamo wena utoya ngonona.
I will go.
Kitoya luena.
And wherever you lodge,
Anamo utoroba langona.
I will lodge.
Kitaroba lahona.
And your people
Batumahau.
Shall be my people.
Itaba batumahisho.
And your God
Mutimwahau.
And my God.
Itaba mutimwaka.
This is referred to the land.
Mataba tabatedi bulelwa lefatsi.
There is something that she saw
wena
in Naomi.
Taba ye a iboni mola go Naomi.
What she saw in Naomi was
taba
God.
And
she realized that if Naomi is going back where she found
that God,
I can rather go back with
her. And
that those people will be my people.
You
know what Ruth said?
Was,
I can see when I look at
you,
I can see that you are only serving God since I met
you.
When I love your son, I also found that you were serving God. So there is something with where you come from. So don't allow me to go back. Allow me to go with you. When I reach there, where you will stay, I will stay. I don't know if you are hearing me. This is the time where God direct your
steps.
I don't know if you're hearing me. And you have conclusions. Or you have words to say. I'm not coming to stay here because of any promise. But I'm here because of God. Naomi was living the life of God. And she was living for God. I don't know if you're hearing me. And she said, I'm coming to lodge with you. To where you are lodging. What I want to do is to experience God, because there is something that you have, is only God. If you stay among the people, I will stay with them. I don't know if you are hearing me. I found that when God this year, when he wants to bless you, he will establish you in the land where he is giving you. I don't know if you are hearing me. You will be in a place when you lodge. You lodge by God. You lodge because you want God. Where you will meet the people of God. But when you are there, you find that you don't have anything you want. But anything will be created by God for your life. I don't know if you are hearing me. There is someone who's listening to me today. I can see the land that God wants to give you. You are in a land also here where God wants you to commit yourself. Listen, Ruth committed herself and say, I'm going with you to the land where you come from, in the land of Judah, because I've seen God in your life. I don't know if you are hearing me. There are times now, when this year when we are beginning, I told people that it's better this year. We don't look for blessings or prophecies or whatever. We look for God. Because if you are in a land of God, then Lord God will visit you and he will direct you and establish you. And it will be the same God Only said those who are speaking the word to speak with you, and those words will come to pass.
Pastor
say, hey, are you in the land that God has planted you? I've read in Genesis 12 from verse 1, when God wants to bless
Abraham,
he said, Abraham, get out from your land of your fathers, because if I bless you, your father Terah worship idols. The praise will be of an idol. So get out from this land, and I will show you a land, and you will be a blessed person. Can I tell you this? There's a land where God wants to plant you. You can get out from the land of your kindness and be planted where God wants to plant you. There are some people here, you don't need the same grounds with your compadre, the same grounds with your friends. You don't need the same grounds with some people. There's a land where God wants to plant you, where you cannot fall. Your rising will be seen by many. This is the year where God will plant you, and your fruits will be visible. The Bible says, Abraham, get out.
Abraham,
he moved out. In Genesis 13, if you read from verse 18, can you just read from verse 8 to 18?
Genesis 13. Abraham said to Lot, please let there be no strife between you and me, and between my headsmen and your headsmen, for we are brethren. Is not the whole land before you? Please separate from me. If you take the left, then I will take the right, or if you go to the right, then I will go to the left. And Lot lifted his eyes and saw all the plain of Jordan, that it was well watered everywhere before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, like the garden of the Lord, like the land of Egypt, as you go towards Zoar. Then Lot chose for himself all the plain of Jordan, and Lot journeyed east, and they separated from each other.
Listen to this. I want you to stop there. You will see that God works by the land. When God wants to speak with you, he check in which land are you. When God wants to bless you, he check which land are you. The Bible says, when Abraham took Lot, after God has spoken, he took Lot, his brother's child. So they become rich in the land where they were in. They start to have headsmen. There were many cows. There were many things. The land becomes small. When the land becomes small, those headsmen began to fight. When they start to fight, the Bible says, Abraham, because he's not a fighter, he's a man of faith. He looked at his brother's son and said, listen, we cannot fight. The land cannot accommodate us. If you look that side, you can see another land. If you look that side, you see another land. So you choose first. I don't know if you're hearing me.
He
said, choose first the land you want to take. This is the man that God spoke of him. I will take you to the land, and I will bless you. Whoever blesses you will be blessed. Whoever curses you will be cursed. So he could not be moved by what is happening on the land. So now the Bible says, Lord, look ahead. He saw Sodom and Gomorrah. In that time, Sodom and Gomorrah was beautiful. It was like a land which was a garden of God.
tsimu ye na ya
mudi ba ke ite
yena shumisha mathwana
ama and he says going there
and how one akeli thakuring lela
when I look at Lot
akilebela Lot
he was beginning to have a competition with his uncle
ai papetsa le rangwane ya
so he decided to choose
yena si side o khetha
by seeing
a khetha ka mathu
and he lived the west to his uncle
le thakure la mudikela
cha the bible says
bible iri
he left there
asipela ya
kuwe
tele cha
when he went
aya
god began to speak with abraham
mutho mabolela le abraham habedi
can I tell you this
rikile bucheng ba
baba there are people who have to go to their land
bona le batho ba tsotsa ba sipela ba mafasing
when you are in the land that god gave you
le fasting le papa mudimo ubele ngolo
you began to hear the voice of god
yo na ka mudimo abule di shana le wena
god began to speak with abraham
mutho mabolela di shana le abraham
habedi
abraham
don't worry
uskabilela
you are going to a land
when now you are lefatseng
and in that land
and lefatseng le uya go lona
generation will take it over
how we na lito cheta ulo
it's not a land
as lefatseng
that your name will die off
ba thuba ba mba
e no
ba
go
bakile
that your name will be remembered
le bitse la ga o leta dola le go pola
this is a land
ja ona lefatseng
that God want to plant you
le bitse mo baba nya go beya go lona
and your surname and your name
fani sa ga ba le bitse la ga le ka selebalo
your children yet not
ba na ba no ba sobelegi
about to speak about you
ubulela ka wena
because of the land
ka le bakala le
fatshe
le mudimo o wele le
bona
theletsa
when lord
yena o lota
was one place
na le tlongwe te
was in one land
na le fatshe le tele abraham
god could not speak with abraham
mudimo o tla bulela le abraham
but it's only when lord
ke ga fela lota
his land
a kgeta le thakore la hae
abraham go is
sipila le thakore la hae
mudimo
o thoma bulela le abraham are ba abraham we
you are sharing lands
ka ndaba le na le abraham na mafatshe le
I'm here to tell you, let them go, you will begin to hear the voice of God
clear.
God wants to speak with you. He wants to take you to a land where you will never be forgotten. He wants to plant you. He wants to search in a place where you will be a blessing. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
God is God of the land.
Mudimo ke mudimo wa lefatshe.
You know when I'm preaching like this.
A ke rera ka mogolo.
I'm beginning to sense Christians.
Ke tsamaya go tswa pholoswa.
Getting land.
Ba thola matsi
mafatshe.
Ba tsamaya ga dinto.
I'm beginning to sense Christians.
Ba pholoswa.
Getting voices.
Ba thoma go bona
ntse. Direct them to a land.
A ba supang tsela ba isa mafatshe. Mafatshe a tlo. Yo ke ngwa ha.
Where the lands will be restored by
us. Mafatshe a tlo busetsa mara go rena.
Yeah, but this is a year.
O go tsamaya tonega fucking wa.
Where you have the land.
O le fatshe la geno
that your forefathers
le la bo papa ga go
overhead
pele o sa tsaka o ka le nna
le
tabuela morago wena
shout hallelujah
ha o tsela nke o re hallelujah
in Genesis 26
Genesis 26
right from 1 to 15
from 1 to 15
you see a famine in Canaan
tala shi fitle kanana
God always uses famine
modimo shumisha tala haolo
and Isaac went to Gerar
Isaka sipela ya Gerar
if you read that the bible says God said
la bible ire modimo pare
do not go to Egypt
usika ye egipita wena Isaka
Genesis
Genesis
26:1-15 if you read there
how ibala
you will hear God speaking with Isaac
le kishana li Isaka
He spoke with Isaac.
Ubulela le Isaka
mo. Isaac.
Are Isaka we?
I understand this.
Ke a fisha one tala.
This famine is there to test.
I gona ulekola.
Sometimes when you are in a land where you are planted, the first thing you'll experience is a famine.
Ke tala.
Famine it means there will be a lack.
Ora uru taba lo thaelela.
When there's a lack,
mona le thaelela.
It means God wants to speak.
Ora uru modimo yo go bolela.
I don't know if you are hearing me.
Ake tseba lentwa.
Can I tell you this?
Ere ke le tlhalo tsheba na.
There's a lack somewhere.
Bona lo thaelelwa ka
ikaya. God wants to speak with you.
Modimo yo go bolela le ngwana wa
Yesu. There's a voice of God.
Bona le le ntshela modimo.
God wants to tell you something.
Modimo yo go bucha taba ye.
And the Bible says.
Ene Bible ya papa
ere. There was that famine.
Ane una le tala yela.
Isaac.
Isaka.
Went to a land of Philistine.
Atsa maya le fetseng la ba Philistine.
He went to move forward
atsamaya tjola pele
Egypt
aya egipeta
and God said Isaac
ndi marisa
don't go to Egypt
sikaya egipeta
stay in the land
dula hana muli
fasi Philistine
la Philistine
when you are there
where how li
I will bless you
kito ushufa
don't know if you hear me
aya tsaba lento
God when he tells you where you belong
awu kutsha ka mwe na
u you meet famine for a while
kana lintala na konyana
e but that famine
na tala ye ya gona ye
is to for a voice of God
no utiro linchela mudimo
be heard by your ears
lelikuwe katsebe cha hao.
That famine you experiencing is for your direction.
Kuti lelo wena obele tupatela yo.
I don't know if you are hearing me.
Na ketse hore le ya ntwana.
So God spoke that.
Tona ngamodimo a bolela.
The Bible says Isaac stay in the land.
Du la lefatsile.
Of Philistine.
La ba Philistine.
And when he was there.
Ena ali lefatsile.
God began to bless him.
Modimo le godimo a thoma moshofa.
On the same year.
Tona ngamwa a bona wo.
Where God spoke.
Bible iri ya modimo a bolechi.
Isaac.
Isaac. Isaac.
Go to Egypt.
O se ka ye Egypt.
Why? Because Egypt.
Why? Ka le ba ka lo re Egypt.
It's a land of slavery.
Ili fasile bohoba.
God doesn't want.
Tona modimo a na sa nyake.
Isaac to be a slave.
O a si sa ka ya le le
khoba. Stay in a land.
Ari du la lefatsile.
Of the fighters.
Le fasile na le o la ba
Philistine. That land.
Ili fasile o la ba
prove that you are the best fighter.
Ita bonjore we na mumbi wa go ka
ona. Prove that you are the one to harvest.
Ita bonjore we na mumbuni ya tabona ka ona.
God allowed
Isaac
to stay in the land of Philistine.
Ore asule fasing la ba Philistine.
Those Philistines.
Ba Philistine ba le
enemies to the Israelites.
Ba ne ba le manna ba ba Israel.
He stay in a land.
Adula le fasing.
Where he had many enemies.
Monna na le manna ba manje.
But he prospered in front of them.
Mara yena atla ya pele ya manna.
Can I tell you this?
Ere ke le thalosetse.
Don't leave the land.
O se ka togala le fasing.
Because of the enemies.
Ka le ba ka la runa le manna ba.
Those enemies you see.
Manna ba na wo bulelang le bona o a bona.
I'm telling you that.
Atalosetse wena ore.
You are going there to prosper.
O ya u tota ya u le gana bona.
Stay there.
Tula gana wo.
God will multiply you.
Ana mo dimo ta watisha.
Some people want to leave jobs.
Ba tsama wena ba nyango togala
le bana. Because of the enemies.
Ka le ba ka la runa le lena.
Some want to do something else.
Ba mo le go dira dilo tshedingwe.
And move from another place to another.
Ba tsama ba tlo ntshedingwe ba tshele
pele. Because of the enemies.
Ka le ba ka la runa le lena.
You see those enemies.
Ha o bona manna ba we.
It means God has given you the land.
Ba pa o file le fatse.
God has given you the land.
Ba pa o file le fatse.
As God has given you the land.
Mo le go dimo o file le fatse.
This God of the land.
Modimo wa lefatshe.
You remember him?
Ha o mo hopola.
When he spoke with Joshua.
Ha bule di tsana le Joshua.
I said Joshua.
Are Joshua we?
Wherever you put
ana
your leg.
Ana mo to beyang le uto ha
la. You are taking the land.
Tsheri lefatshe leo.
Listen to this.
Seletsa wana papa.
Taking the land means.
Tsheri lefatshe ora ore.
Dominating.
O tsheta ulo.
Taking the land means.
O tsheri lefatshe ora ore.
Having possession.
O tsheri ntoka o felete
ditse. Taking the land means.
O tsheri lefatshe ora ore.
You are ruling.
Wena we are busa.
Taking the land means.
O tsheri lefatshe ora ore.
You are overcoming.
Ya vita
there are many people who are here
baba nchima linkedin
I see you taking your land
wewe now chale fatsila gae
I say you are taking the land
wewe now chale fatsila gae
you be in a land
wewe now le fatsi
where you dominate
wewe bona utachia
tawo I don't fear hear me
make the holy
apostle prophesy someone
you prophesy a mutu
preaching and preaching
oh mutu ta yake irela
prophesy of someone
prophesy a mutu
people will hear
ta tuma takwa
your name
papa le bichona
in that land
kana le fatsile
do you know what happened to Joshua
what's about the king Joshua
when Joshua was on the other side
Joshua le kan thengela
of Jerusalem
ya Jerusalem ya Jordan
let me say of Jordan
ya Jordan
and Jericho was on the other
Jericho
side
Jericho le ka moshola
before he even reached there
a so fitika moshola
they were talking about
ba se tiba bulela ka yena
they say hey we know
but you are yet saying
the god of this people
modimo wa bathoba
they said they were trembling
ba re ne ba thuthumela
they are coming to take the land
ba to tshetulo ya rena
they are coming to take the land
ba ye ta ba to tshetulo ya rena
this people of Jericho
wana papa ba tshwa Jericho
they had big walls
ba na bana le mabota matelele
but god used
mara modimo le godimo a shumisa
the silence of
the humula botela ba ba
shout of the
No huele talita tira mafelelo
break all the walls
uroba mapota ka ufela
they were defeated
ene mahlulwa
I see you
ke bona wena
dominating this
land uchakaulo wa hawoke
where you put your land
ana mawe no to hata
you are taking the land
uchali fatsileo
say I'm taking the land
nna ke chali fatse
there is something I saw in Thando
ona li ntoki bona enko Thando
which I want to tell you
ere ke le thalo setseng yo
and I met this lady
ke kopanele sesisho
she came to see me one on one
o ila tampona one on one
she said there's something that is happening
aruna le ntongwe ya diala
there are these people of this nation in
tona le batha ba le shwe ba le shabalela kae kae
what they're doing
tswe ba idiang asi
if they occupy this house
ha ba ka tsena ka rantwe
and you are a neighbor
and when I'll make
you are about to sell your house to them
o rekisha ntwe wa ba rekisha
when they are there
ka ra ha ba le mo
they will be praying
you
are moving
la uru wa sipile
taking over
we are not getting checked out
I don't know if you are hearing me
I get several lento
I don't know if you are hearing me
I get several lento na
say I want to dominate
there is nothing you go check out
I want Christians today
kenya kama pulso le khone
or Christians this year to have lands, to have lands where no one cannot compete
with.
Because when we look at Isaac, the Bible says when the Philistines saw that he has prospered, they envy him. Listen, if people are not envying you, you are not yet you. If people are not competing you, the real you has come out. This is the time that the real you has come forth, because they are hearing the sound of your feet when you want to take over the land. I don't know if you are hearing me. I see someone here is about to take the land, is about to take the house, is about to throw it in. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Take someone and say, hey, I'm about to let me show you scriptures. Maybe you will understand what I'm saying. We are serving God who wants to plant you in a land, and nobody can do anything about it. In John 4, from verse 1 to 4, I want you to read, Mama. John 4, I want to show you something.
Verse 1 to 4, read. Therefore,
uh-huh,
when the Lord knew that the Pharisees had heard that Jesus made a baptized disciple than John, though Jesus himself did not baptize,
uh-huh,
but his disciples, he left Judea and departed into Galilee. But he needed to go through Samaria. So he came to a city of Samaria, which is called Sychar, near the plot of ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph.
Stop there. What I want to tell you is, the Bible says, listen to this. Understand this. Remember that Jesus was born in Bethlehem. It was Judea. When Jesus was born there, remember there was a king. King Herod was still ruling. I want to explain to you so that you understand this. And now, the wise people who came with all the gifts and presented them to the parents of Jesus, after they've received, the angel came and said, run away to Egypt with this boy, because king Herod wanted to kill him. Okay, look what happened there. The Bible says he went to Egypt. When King Herod died, the same angel came and say, go back, because the enemy, go back to the land, because the enemy who wanted to kill the son has died. And the Bible says they came back. They were going to
Bethlehem.
When they were going back to the land where Jesus was born, because I will tell you about when you were born, it's a problem where you were born. When they were going there, the Bible says Joseph heard that the son of Herod is a king, and he realized that, oh, Herod is enemy now. They turn back to Nazareth. They go to Galilee. When they were in Galilee, the time of the festival came.
Festival,
when Jesus was already baptized with the Holy Spirit, the time of festival came. Are you hearing me? When that time came, Jesus was forced to go to Jerusalem. When he reached Jerusalem, everybody was talking about what he's doing, because what he did, he changed wine in Cana of Galilee. He was in Galilee, and he was doing things, but those things were reaching Jerusalem. When it was reaching Jerusalem, they heard that Jesus is coming. Everybody were hearing that Jesus is coming. But when Jesus reached there, he could not even waste time. He saw people there, selling things. He takes shambok and hit them. And now, already, there were some people wanted to see him. So Jesus started to baptize. I don't know if you're hearing me. When he started to baptize, the Bible says John the Baptist was baptizing in Jordan. And now, those people began to hear, Jesus is baptizing many people than John. Now, the Pharisees, when they hear that, they began to be envious. They say, we want to see him. And Jesus disappeared. He knew that his ministry will get competition if he stayed very close to Jerusalem. And the Bible says he went back to Nazareth and he went to Galilee. He continued with the ministry. Listen to this. There are times where your enemies are bounding. Sometimes God will be telling you, you're in a land where you will get competition. You need to know where God has to raise you. And the Bible says, he moved to Galilee. Miracles start to happen. Everything start to happen. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Everybody was intimidated. He was doing that in the desert. Very close to the sea. When in the city, there was nothing that was happening. I'm here to tell you, when that God gives you a land away from the city, God can still raise you to do things that can be admired in the city. You can be far away from the city, but your works can explode in the city. I see someone here today who can be blessed, and the city will know your name. If you believe, shout hallelujah. If you are in a place where God planted you, fear nothing. Go away from competitors. Do what you are called. Stay focused. And the God who called you will see you through. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I'm in a land that God has planted. I'm in a land where he planted me. I want to tell you about my story. One time, my late spiritual father, he said, he wanted me to go to
Midrand
and hold a church in Midrand and also in Winnie Mandela. And he said the church in
Midrand
will support the church in Winnie Mandela. Listen, that night when I'm sleeping, I saw myself standing on top of a big mountain. And then when I looked down, I saw that mountain was written, it's Winnie
Mandela.
Everybody was coming from the caves, running up. And then by that dream, I concluded. I spoke with my father. I said, my father, I understand. I know your heart. You are looking at Winnie Mandela as nothing now.
Who
can support me. But I had a dream. And this dream, I saw God taking me on top of the mountain. And when I'm there, everybody was running to me. And that mountain was Winnie Mandela. Today, Winnie Mandela. Tembisa is known all over the world. But that time, I told my father, I said, please, let's allow God to do what he said. He says, you are right, my son. When I came to Winnie Mandela, I felt pity of you. How are you going to survive?
jwangu wini Mandela.
That's why I say,
that's why
let's allow God to do his way.
Let me
try to tell you. Some lands where you are, it's like there's no provision. But God is about to provide for you. You're in a place when people look at you, they say shame on you.
Shame on
but let me try to tell you. You are in a place where everybody will run for help coming to you in the name of Jesus. Tell somebody, say, hey, I'm in my land. God has planted me here. I'm in my land. I cannot be defeated here. I'm in my land. When I sow, I reap. When I sow, I harvest. Can I tell you this? As God has planted you now, I'm about to see wrong people leaving you. Don't ask them why. Allow them to go. God will direct you. When he starts to direct you, he will bless you. I see God blessing you. I see God lifting you. Tell your neighbor, say, hey, God is blessing me. God is lifting me. It's possible. It's possible. I went to another land. When I reached that land, everybody was saying there's a criminal. It's a criminal that stays there. The person that was selling me
arms
was a white lady, and there were white people everywhere. Because my cars were parked around the house, they could not find any name to define me except to say criminal. I don't know if you're hearing me. And from there, the woman came and said, these people are complaining. Since I come to you, I've never asked you the job you're doing. And I say, I'm a pastor. She took her hands and put in her hands. I said, all these people say you're a criminal. I said, yes, I understand. Because when you take over the land, those who think you're not fit, they must come with assumptions. They come with things with their perspectives. They think you are using something. They think you are using something, or you are in a wrong business. This year, the people of Charis, you are about to intimidate your enemies. I say you are about to intimidate. I don't know if you are hearing me. Say I'm taking the land. Say I'm taking the land. It's where the Lord has planted me. It's where God has planted me. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Let's read maybe the last verse, please. Look at this one, Joshua 24.
Joshua 24.
1 to 8.
1 to 8.
You can also read Deuteronomy 28, verse 1.
Revelation 28, verse 1.
But just read Joshua 24.
Joshua 24, verse 1 to verse 8.
Read, Mama.
Then Joshua gathered all the tribes of Israel to Shechem and called for the elders of Israel over their heads, for their judges, and for their officers, and they presented themselves before God. And Joshua said to all the people, thus says the Lord God of Israel, your fathers, including Terah, the father of Abraham and the father of Nahor, dwelt on the other side of the river in old times, and they served other gods. Then I took your father Abraham from the other side of the river, led him through all the land of Canaan, and multiplied his descendants, and gave him Isaac. To Isaac I gave Jacob and Esau, and to Esau I gave the mountain of Seir to possess. But Jacob and his children went down to Egypt. Also, I sent Moses and Aaron, and I plagued Egypt according to what I did among them. Afterward, I brought you out. Then I brought your fathers out of Egypt, and you came to the sea, and Egyptians pursued you, your fathers, with chariots and horsemen to the Red Sea. So they cried out to the Lord, and he put darkness between you and the Egyptians, brought the sea upon them, and covered them. And your eyes saw what I did to Egypt. Then you dwelt in the wilderness a long time. And I brought you into the land of the Amorites, who dwelt on the other side of the Jordan. And they fought with you, but I gave them into your hands, that you might possess their land. And I destroyed them from before you.
Can you hear how God from the beginning, he was minding about the land? You know, not long I found that all of you know that everybody is talking about land in South Africa. I was just crying and saying, if we get the land and we don't know what we are going to do with it. Can you see, you just have a farm, cry to get the land, just to build, we fill the land without plying in the land,
without.
You see, when God gave Israelites the land, he was using his servants. When he used Moses, he said, okay, I'm taking you to the land of Canaan. When he used Joshua,
we are
taking you to a land that which is not yours. This land is not yours. I wanted to tell you something that maybe will worry you. God just wants you to possess the land. He just wants you to just possess the land. He wants you to find a house being built. You don't build it. He just wants you to take even the house, the properties, the animals around there. That's how God was doing in the beginning. He says, I'm taking you to a land of milk and honey. And this is the land of other people. Here God says, I destroy all of them. He didn't say he destroyed them with animals and their
furniture.
He destroyed all of them. But they took over everything. You know, our people would, I know what they normally do. It's only when someone is dead that they want to take something. And they begin to fight, attacking each other. Here we are talking about something that when you take it, nobody will fight against you. There's something that God wants to give you, and you are going to possess it, and without no competition. I see you building that house. I see you honoring that land. I see you having your heart desire. Listen to this. In this year of Jubilee, I want to have testimonies of lands, properties.
The property.
I mean, I want to hear you dominating. It's a year that you must dominate. I can't believe you are hearing me. I can't believe you are hearing me. I'm expecting people of Charis to have more than 5 houses. Randy, you are landlord. Landlord, you are moving forward. I don't know if you are hearing me. Can you receive your land? Can you be in a land that God is planting you? Can you be in a land where you will be fruitful? Can you be in a land where God is requiring you? I see the fruits of you this year. Will shame your enemies in the name of Jesus. Just stand up. God bless you.